kind of instrument which is not sharp. It can be a Heidemann, it can be a ball burnish, it can be anything, because the sharp parts can tear the rubber. And maybe that's all what we need. And of course, I don't know if I mentioned the frame. So, we have three different options how to apply, two or subclasses. Options how to apply rubber then. First option, place the rubber, hold it in place, then place the clamp. Second option, place the clamp. After that, pull the rubber through the clamp, or push through the clamp through the rubber. And the third option, when you place the clamp and the rubber together. And the two subclasses for this is if the clamp has wings or if it's a wingless clamp. Okay, I will show you all. So, first of all, how to decide where to make the holes. We have this template. We have maxillar and mandibular arch. They are a bit different. And we have adult and child, but I do not recommend for you to try to place rubber than for child, really. So try to use materials which are not that sensitive for moisture and with that you can work much faster, for example glass enamel, then you don't have to use rubber then. Okay, let's say for the first case we want to place the clamp on the lower six and the two neighbors. First mark it through the template. Then 7, 6 and the 5. And it should be a good idea to mark which one is, for example, the lower right corner. Just to place an X, because when your assistant gives it to you, after punching the hole, you just have to check, okay, if it's like this, or this, or this. And if you just make a small cross in the corner, then you will know how to place it. Okay, the puncher. Small hole, medium, and big hole. In this case, we have a premolar. For that, I will make a medium hole. Be sure that the dot is in position. Then press it. Maybe it's a good idea to pull around the rubber, because if the puncher is not sharp enough, it can leave some small rubber particle in the center, and when you want to remove it, you will tear the whole rubber. And I will make one side bigger for the molar. One for the six. For the 7. Okay. Check it, be sure that you have the proper sizes. Okay. First the rubber, then the clamp. It's always a good idea to have an assistant. In this case, we don't have to use an assistant because now I can place the rubber to the patient's throat, but in real patient, the assistant can hold the upper corners so you can work more easily. And then I think the best way is always to place the rubber dam on the most distal tooth. Okay, so in this case we'll place it on the 7. After that, place it on the 6. And then you can place it on the 5. It's a bit difficult for these plastic teeth because they are so dry and the rubber sticks to them. For the endo pre-exam, you can use lubricants. In patients, you don't really need to use lubricants because there's a lot of saliva, which will make it easier to apply. Okay, the rubber is on. Next step, made a mistake. Before you place the rubber, you have to try on the clamp to be sure that it fits properly. For this case, for example, I can choose a lower, or this is a universal molar. You can see both of the faces are smooth. And it's wingless. but it's not a problem now because first I placed the rubber, then I placed the clamp. First I've tried it on, hopefully it will fit, and now I will place it on the 7. You should ask your assistant or together, you should keep the rubber away from the tooth. So when you place the clamp, you do not risk to place the rubber between the gum and the... Not that easy because we have quite a huge fifth class. But I will try to do it. So you always have to be sure that the rubber is between the clamp and the gum, because then it can isolate. And another important thing, the patient, the dentist and the assistant should wear eye protection during the process, because sometimes it can happen that there's some problem with the tooth shape, it's too tapered or the clamp is not the best, and then if you jump off, and just be sure that you don't damage yourself. Okay, you always check with your hands if it fits. If it's moving or if it's loosened, then replace it for another one. After this, you should apply the frame. So we have the clamp on, all the teeth are involved, we should place the frame. Not like this, and not like this. You will see it has a curvature. Not all of the frames are like this, but this one has a curvature here, and the face has a curvature too. So try to fit them, okay? Because in this shape, it's not that really comfortable. And you should do it together with the assistant. First, the upper ones, then the lower ones. It has some small spines here that will help you to fix the rubber. Okay, so it's something like this. And if you have enough material, then you can make a small pocket to the bottom. If you use any liquid which goes there, it's not going to flow down on the patient's chest, but it will be collected here. Or you can even place cotton rolls here. Then you can replace them during the process. So this is how it looks like. In this case, we are lucky because we have quite huge proximal spaces. So we don't have to use the floss, but in most of the cases, we have to use the floss, the dental floss, just to be sure that the rubber crosses the proximal contact junction. Okay, so we have to push it down because then you can have the best isolation. And here it's quite fixed, but can you see it from there?
No.
I think you're quite big guys, so you can come here to the background and you can
he
see.
He has to send the third woman.
Okay, so here we don't have to need any nasal fixation, but if it's necessary, for example, you can use a wedge. Pull down the rubber. And place the wedge, then it's much more fixed. Okay, but sometimes it's not necessary. Okay, this was option number one. How to remove it. First, if there's any wedge or rubber ligature, you have to remove that. After that, you have to remove the frame. And it's important that if you did some root canal treatment or preparation, so there's some liquid in the rubber, first before you remove the frame, dry it with the cotton roll or something like that, because if you remove the frame and just leave it like this, it can go to the patient's mouth or in the patient's clothes. Okay, when you're done, remove the clamp. And for example, if you made an MOD or some second class filling, maybe the approximate contact point is very, very tight. In that case, sometimes you cannot remove it just by pulling. Then you have to cut these parts with the scissor. Okay? Mm. In this case, I can remove it and I don't want to cut because we don't have too much rubber. And you always have to check when you have removed it that you have all the parts, all the connecting parts. Because it can happen that it's torn into that area. Then you have to look for it and remove it, because it can start some quite serious gingivitis, so we don't want to have that. Okay, option number one, when you place the rubber, then the clamp. Option number two, when we place the clamp together with the rubber, can I have a molar clamp?
Yeah, that's what
it's premolar. ring glass.
We don't have this. We don't have
this. Is, yeah. This is molar with the wing.
Mm-hmm. Where is the wing?
On the side. So here is the difference. Oh, okay. Mister. Okay. Mm-hmm. So winged or wingless? If you have wing, then first, of course, you have to try it on. And after that, you use the wings to fix the rubber on. Like this. Mm. Can you see that? Okay. So you don't have to use the movie maker to make effects. Mm-hmm. I'll do it. Okay. And again, the assistant helps you. And it's much more visible for you. You have to be careful to keep away the rubber for both maxillary and distal. Just to be sure that the clamp fits on the tooth and the nut on the rubber. If you look at the jaws, then you have to reposition them. Okay, after this, the first step, and that's where you have to use some not sharp instrument. You have to remove the rubber from the wings. You can see even this one can tear it. And this one is quite a hard type of rubber sheet. So if you have a more elastic one, a soft one, and this one is much easier to remove. And maybe if it's not that dry, it can be used much more easily. And lingual it too. And these are removed from the wings. Then it's the same way, you have to apply it on the adjacent piece. Like this. Check with the floss if they've passed the approximate contact point. If necessary, then fix it with wedge, and then you're done. And of course, the frame and all the rest. Okay. What if we want to do the same thing with the wingless clamp? We can do it, because then we will use this connection area, this bracket part, for the fixation. And you will fix it just like this. The connection area. Okay. That. Use the forceps. Of course, in mouse it's a bit more difficult. Place it on the tooth. Check it if it fits. Then, in the same way, pull it through. It's a bit easier because you don't have the wings, which can disturb this placement. And after that, just place on the two other teeth. And it fits. Okay. And the last one, and I've left it for the last one because sometimes it's not a successful attempt to try place a clamp. Maybe I will do it with wingless because it's a bit easier. First, place the clamp. The advantage is that if you place the clamp itself only without rubber, then you can be sure that it fits in the best position. And then you have to try to pull it through. So you must have rubber, which is quite elastic and not going to torn during the process. Pull it through the connection area. And after that, the same way, lead it to its final place. Okay? And then place it on the other piece and you're done. Okay, these are the four main types how to apply it with the clamp. And maybe I will show you one more thing. One more thing that you can do for front piece. Let's say from three to three. I will use a bit smaller holes. Trying to find the dots. There. Okay. For front teeth, I think the best is first place the rubber dam and after that try to fix it somehow. And maybe you should start with the central incisors. Because if you check the template and if you check the holes, there's always a bit bigger space between the central incisors than between the other ones. So that's the most difficult to place. If you have placed it, after that the rest is not that difficult. Placed on the central ones, place it to the rest. Okay. And now, here we have a problem with the proximal area. You can see they are still on the contact point. So, in this case, we should use the floss and try to.